Y'all doing all right today out there, man? Ooh. Yeah, but give it out. They shut down the church today, so we couldn't get in the church, but that's all right, because we gonna stay. You know, if there's two or three in the midst, that's just three people in total, maybe two, you know, and so we still have to do what we have to do, amen. You know, you don't want to be caught in a time like this where you don't want to be able to do what you need to do. So, Rev, what you're saying is about to drop something. So I want y'all to go right now to the book of Anoint Me. And in there, we talk about cleaning up the house. Amen. So it says in the book, it says that, wherefore art thou that has been absent from the building? Thee that you may have to go in and partake up in the cleanup. There is thou, though them and those, that whichever have cleaned up their place, now do diligently to others. I'm going to stop right there. We're going to get right into the word. See, because what it's saying there is that, you know, so much is going on right now that we have begin to look at everything in another place of life. Amen. And we sometimes don't understand that we have to continue to do what we need to do. See, I take it to a time in life when I had diarrhea, you know, and it was all up in me and I couldn't get it out. And I began to move and I thought this thing inside me was the devil. And I realized that I had just ate some bad food that day. And so I began to get to the house and I got to the house and I got in the restroom and I began to put my poop spray down in there and I shut down and I began to release. And then it just started running like water and food had mixed together. And I started saying to myself, this can't be of God, because I know I shouldn't be feeling this inside. But the more and more it kept running up out of me in a juice form that was heavily mixed with cornbread and chicken, I began to feel better. I think somebody out there about to get moved today. Because I realized then all the mess that was up in me was coming out of me. Reverend, what you're saying? What I am saying is that sometimes it takes diarrhea to clean out the mess inside of you. Amen. Because some of you sitting in here right now full of mess and you need to just have an episode of diarrhea to get all the mess up out of you. But Rev, what are you saying? What I am saying that you need to get you some Pepto-Bismol or you need to get some prune juice and let it run and get all the filth up out of you. But Rev, what are you saying? I'm saying it's time that you clean up your own house. You've been sitting around for the last 2 weeks and not being able to do nothing, then your house is still looking a mess. You know, sometimes you gotta put stuff in place and put it in order. But Rev, what you're saying, what I am saying is, quit posting up everything on Facebook talking about other people's mess and your house still got clothes all over the bed. You still got stuff hanging on the closet. You still got tissue now all over the bathroom. But Rev, what are you saying? I'm saying that you've been running around buying up all this toilet paper and you don't have enough sense to stick the toilet paper and put some up and have it for the rainy day. Because when I go to Walmart, I got to run down the aisleway and I'm sitting here now finna have to use one of my towels because you got all the tissue from all of all the places in the world. But Rev, what you're saying, what I'm saying is every time I go into Family Dollar now and I try to get a loaf of bread, they tell me I can only have one. But I got five kids in the house and everybody wants a sandwich. But Rev, what are you saying? I am saying to you that if you're going to take all the tissue, please let a neighbor borrow some or something, because some of us don't have any and we're sitting around here trying to use the restroom and probably gonna have to use an old t-shirt to clean up our mess.
But Rev, what are you saying? I'm saying it's time for you to get those clothes up off your bed because your house needs to get in order. You've been sitting around here complaining about the 5G towers. Well, I got something to tell you about my computer tower. I need to update it, but I can't even get it to Best Buy right now because guess what they told me? They shut down for COD. They don't want to get me on through the door and get in there and get what I need. But Rev, what are you saying? What I am saying is, if I have to keep sitting in this house in the manner that I am in, I'm going to start to kill people. I don't mean that literally. I don't mean it figuratively. I am meaning it technically because I have nothing else to do. And the only thing that you can do at that point is to put your hands around somebody's throat and choke it till they can't breathe, till they're wheezing out your mouth. But Rev, what are you saying? What I am saying is, I ain't even had time to go post up my Marilyn Monroe picture, huh? Because I can't get no nails. Why? Because all the stores are shut down. But Rev, what are you saying? I am saying that for some odd reason, this same bear has been sitting in my closet, floating and peeping in and out on me every night. And I don't know why, but it's scaring the living daylights out of me when I wake up at 3 a.m. trying to figure out what I'm going to do for the day. But Rev, what are you saying? What I am saying is, when you have nothing else to do in life, you put a coat on in the house, get in front of your phone, and begin to talk about what it is you can't do because everybody else can't do, right? But Rev, what are you saying for a minute? I am saying, why the hell did I go buy this new TV that ain't even a smart TV? It's a dumb TV. The TV just looks at me and nothing happens unless I hook my fire stick up to it. But my son stole my fire stick because he wanted to put it on his TV. But Rev, what are you saying with it? I am saying that if you ain't got the corona, don't be posting about the corona because it ain't hit you yet, owner, if you want to talk about the corona. But Rev, what are you saying right now? I'm saying that they're talking about suspending your utilities, but your people better keep paying on your bills because when all this is over, they gonna want their money. And if you don't give them their money, they gonna do something funny. But Rev, what are you saying? I'm saying they gonna cut some stuff off. You gonna get into the month of May and realize you ain't got lights. You ain't got power. You ain't got water. You ain't got any sources. Your cable is going off because you didn't pay the bills, but they thought you could take time off because people are dealing with the Rona. But I'm telling you, you better pay your owner. But Rev, what are you saying? I'm saying that you don't want to get caught May 15th, 2020 with your bills not paid up. They said they're going to send you a check in a couple weeks, and most of them are still going to put it on their car. Most of them are still going to put it in the bar that ain't even open yet. But Rev, what are you saying? I'm saying that you better get rid of this diarrhea that's inside of you. Get yourself cleaned out because the thing is about to happen and we're about to make a move because stuff is coming at you like that and daily and daily. But Rev, what are you saying? I am saying I'm about to go now because I done told you everything that you need to know. And if you don't want some more, undertune in because I'll come back for those who need to know. But Rev, what are you saying? I'm saying goodbye.